Linguistically, Muhammad means praiseworthy and Paul means small. After 9/11, I had to change my name from praiseworthy to small. When we registered for school, my dad traded in his heritage for my safety. When he signed me up as small instead of Muhammad, I was confused, but I was too young to speak up. So from grades pre-K to second grade, I was Paul Yunus from a family of unbearded men. Dad said it was dangerous to be too Muslim right now. And isn't that so American? To confuse school with a battleground, to take my name from me as if it is a beast to be tamed, as if Islam is so dangerous they had to rip the teeth out the jaws of my name to take something worthy of praise and make it so small. With Muhammad hidden, my last name became target practice for my classmates. Mispronouncing Yunus was a pastime, a punchline to a joke. No, it's not Jonas or Nunez. Yes, I am an immigrant. No, I'm not Mexican. Yes, I am Muslim. No, I'm not a terrorist. Islam and terror became synonymous to each other, like the right to live became synonymous to not being colored. How much more of me do I need to erase for America to feel comfortable? To be young and Muslim in America is to be in a constant state of apology. I'm sorry, Muhammad is so hard to spell. I'm sorry, I gotta go pray right now. I'm sorry, my mom wears the hijab. I'm sorries, just keep on stacking. Apology has become the 51st state in this great nation where people have color yearn for a blank slate. I'm constantly apologizing in tongues that are not my own. Do I get to decide what Muhammad means, or am I just supposed to be small? Because Muhammad sounds like planes crashing into towers, right? Sounds like a bomb threat, a gun cock clicked and shot, families broken, degenerate scum, a threat to the American way of life that's oh so precious. The home of the brave is controlled by fear and paranoia. Can't swallow anything that's not convenient, but my name is Muhammad, and it bears on its back the people that came before it. Praiseworthy, the boxer that put his fist down because he knew words wound oppressors in ways that cannot heal. Praiseworthy, the prophet that begged for his enemies' forgiveness even though they were hunting him down. Praiseworthy, the poet that chose to write kindness in a world numb by hate. Praiseworthy is when I sing off key. Praiseworthy feels like freestyling over a beat. Praiseworthy is always dancing by myself because I am my own party. Let my name drip out the speakers of my 1998 Toyota Corolla, volume on max, drowning out the engine troubles and not caring because at least the car's still going. The car's still going through break beats and broken home. Praiseworthy took something small and grew up to be Muhammad.
Give it up one more time for Muhammad.